On Thursday, the 22nd of April 2021, I decided to find the courage to go out and deal with the errands that have been piling up because I have not been going out of the house. The pandemic is still on, and the new positive cases of COVID in my city is increasing, so I and most of my family members really haven't been going out at all, but things needed to be done out of the house, so I tried to be brave and went out. I made sure that I had my alcohol disinfectant spray and my face masks and my face shields. I first went to the shopping mall. It is called Robinson's, and I actually like the parking area better here because the lighting is brighter and the floors are cleaner and more rough, so there is less chance of me slipping. And the first errand of the day is to drop by a Western Union in the mall to get my YouTube revenues for the month. The process is fully electronic. I was asked to sign on this little pad, and I also used my USSC Supercard as identification. USSC is the affiliate of this particular Western Union branch. As you can see, YouTube paid me over $145, which converts to over 6,900 Philippine pesos. I don't get revenues every month, I get them every other month. And the staff here at Western Union actually asked me why Google was sending me money, and I told him I had a YouTube channel, and he went on his phone and checked out my YouTube channel and subscribed. I'm always happy to have a new subscriber. The next errand was to drop by the LBC, that is two stores away from the Western Union, because I had to mail off a tea strainer for a friend. And then I dropped by the National Bookstore to look for a particular glue. I did find it, but not in the large size that I wanted. But I got whatever I could anyway. And I also didn't find the 200 GSM card stock that I needed for the covers of the handmade notebooks that I need to make for my customers. But I did also pick up some sticky notes that I needed. I use a lot of these when reading books and doing my research. I also dropped by this store over here. This is Yo-Yo So. I think this is inspired by Miniso because they have pretty much the same items. There's makeup, self-care, and this fan that is USB powered, which I actually like, but I'm not sure if the breeze is strong enough for what I needed to do, and it's a little expensive. There are speakers here, and this one says, "I am a speaker." I'm sure you are, dear. Water bottles, towels. I didn't buy anything. And then I dropped by Daiso to stock up on Ziploc bags. I also use up a lot of the Ziploc bags in packing up the items that I am destashing. And I also picked up this pack of AAA batteries and a spray bottle, which I will use for what else but alcohol disinfectant. And after Daiso, I walked over to the nearby Watson's, which is still in the same mall, and I got the aloe vera gel for Jawaid. He uses it on his scalp. And I also got dental floss for my son. And I finally found that lavender scented body wash from Dove, and I also got two sheet masks for myself. And when I paid for my items, I was informed that I have a free packing cube, so yay! And then I went back to my car because I had to drive to a different shopping building. I tried very hard to be quick with the errands. I didn't want to stay in one place for very long because of COVID, and it felt so unnatural to me. I always like taking my time when deciding on what to buy, but I have to be safe and I have to make decisions quickly. And it was actually quite nice to finally be able to deal with some errands. It gave me some semblance of normalcy in these not so normal times. And this here is Angena Trading, and this is where I bought the 200 GSM card stock the last time. And when I went in, I found that they did not have the glue that I needed, but I picked up a bottle of this one anyway. And I also use this particular glue for the spine of the handmade notebook, so I can never have enough of these. As for the 200 GSM cardstock, they didn't have it available, so I decided to try out this one. And I also got myself an A4 sized basic clipboard. After paying for my items, I went to my car again, and then I drove to the drugstore called Mercury Drug to buy my prescription medication and some vitamins, which are also prescribed as usual with my person with disability documentation, so I can get the 20% discount. I waited in this waiting area for senior citizens and persons with disabilities. The drugstore was a little bit crowded, so I felt uncomfortable, but the moment I got in, the transaction was very, very quick. I started my errands at around 4 p.m. and it is now 16 minutes past 6. Then I dropped by Knopper, which is nearby, to buy that one medication that's not available at Mercury Drug. And then I ended up in this other shopping mall. Remember the shopping mall that did not honor the parking privileges of persons with disability? I talked about it in a previous vlog, which I will link below. This is the same mall right here. I looked for honey here in the supermarket, but I couldn't find real honey, just this honey-flavored syrup, which I didn't buy. And then I went to the National Bookstore here to look for the glue that I needed, and I found only one in the size that I wanted, and I got that. I also picked out a couple of writing pads, a roll of bubble wrap, which I will be using to pack the handmade notebooks before shipping them out. And then I went upstairs to look for clipboards. I found this really nice, sturdy, minimal clipboard with a cover, and it is in black, and it also has a semi-transparent white version, but I was worried that it might get dirty easily, so I decided to get the black one in folio size. So that also made me decide to get only the yellow writing pad, which is also very close to folio size, and not the white intermediate writing pad, which is a strange size anyway. And see, over there is where I got the glue. After I paid for my items, I went out, totally forgetting to buy the large roll of bubble wrap. I am reminded of the bubble wrap only when I was editing this video because I saw a video clip of it. But anyway, there were also a few things that I wasn't able to take care of on that day. I wasn't able to load up an e-wallet with funds, and I wasn't able to take my car for a wash and wax, but those are not urgent and those don't need to be accomplished on this day. I dropped by Joe White's house and then we decided to have dinner out. This place belongs to a friend of ours. It's called Paseo del Rio. This is a small restaurant, but they also cater food during specific events. They have a section for outdoor dining, and that's where we stayed because it's safer from the virus. The food is very good here. And I'm really intrigued by this hibiscus red iced tea. Jawad and I didn't stay long. After we had dinner, we went home. And strangely enough, when I got home, my dad and one of our household staff were outside in the carport because they saw a large snake right outside our kitchen door. This has never happened before. So much for normalcy.